this car.
No, we didn't. We're good. That was terrible. That's a nice car right there. Sorry, boss. Hey, Nico Bellic, what are you gonna do?
There he is. Welcome to the war council, my boy.
Gentlemen.
War council.
What's going on?
Not
my speakers, dude.
Discussing pest control.
Well, I've given you my advice, Peg. You do what you think is best.
I agree.
Finally.
I mean, I don't agree with what he says. I agree that you know best.
Excuse me?
Relax. I didn't mean nothing by it. Look, either we make the right call or we all end up in prison anyway. Well, your crap ain't gonna do me no favors.
Be careful. I'll see you later. Boss, gentlemen.
You're only an associate, Phil. Remember that.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, tough
guy. Boss, I gotta tell you this. He's not straight. Right before I came in here, I saw him talking to Angie again.
You better leave. I need to speak to Nico.
Sure, boss. But, think about what I said.
I will.
You know?
Trust me on that. We got
Ray's
real
bringing
problems.
Up the boss's woman.
Police are all over us. Maybe you heard. I got served papers today.
Didn't hear.
Phil yesterday. We got a couple of boys
Phil
in jail.
Bell got papers?
I think they might squeal. Somebody's talking. Wants us out of the picture. Maybe John Gravelli.
Oh, shit.
What them Ancelotti's?
Jimmy's all crazy.
Somebody got to my people.
So what are you going to do about it?
Kill them all.
I don't know. I gotta shut someone up and show people I mean business. I've known Phil a long time. He's straight, more or less. I know him and Angie are friends, but that don't worry me too much.
Okay.
Maybe he's too straight. Then there's Ray.
Whoa.
I don't know.
What the fuck?
I don't trust him.
Jimmy.
But he's a good earner.
Oh, Nico's just sick of this shit.
He tries, but he's no dummy. Him and Phil hate each other.
Nico's so sick of this.
I gotta think about it.
Okay.
I'll give you a call. Whoever I say to go see him. And shut him up!
He's way down there in the bottom left. What the fuck is that? Nice shot of his curtains, though, I suppose. Nice bird curtains, honey! Yeah, fuck it. I'm taking your car, Jimmy. Okay, so he's gonna call me and tell me to kill Phil or to kill Ray. Do I get a choice? Like, Playboy and Dwayne? Because I'll kill Ray in a second. I mean, I like Ray. I don't know why Nico hates Ray. I kind of like him. But, at the same time, Phil's awesome. I really like Phil. Okay. Nothing else going on. Let's head to the freaking weapons store.
Like you knew it so far from heaven. This traffic is fucking bullshit.
Traffic's bullshit. I thought it was bullshit. Okay, I am more in favor of killing Ray than I am of killing Phil, so sure. Just gonna go load up on ammo first. Seems like the judicious thing to do. Whoa, fuck! I didn't realize I was gonna take that turn. Fight so wide.
Motherfucker.
That guy almost didn't survive. Okay, now I know I'm pretty good on body armor here.
We know how to use them.
But I will re-up if, even, I mean, it's 500 bucks, but who cares? And I'm more concerned about ammo of various types. Because you never know.
See you again, shooter.
Stay safe. Stay Second Amendment. I kind of don't want to drive that car anymore. Ooh. Hummer. Why drive on the road when you can drive over the road? Yeah. Where are we going? Going to see Ray. He's in... Oh, God. Oh, also, I looked it up last time. There are actually a ton of projects in Manhattan. There's tons of projects all over New York City. I should have known better. Manhattan's just such a large borough that, of course, there would be public housing projects there. But anyway, yes, a number of projects in the Manhattan borough. Pretty much every borough in Queens has got at least like a dozen different housing projects, public housing projects. I read a really interesting article, actually not an article, it's a book. So this guy named Blair Kamen, he was, I don't know if he still is or not, he was the architecture critic for the Chicago Tribune, Chicago Sun-Times, one of the two. Anyway, Chicago's a big, architecture's a big deal in Chicago. I lived there for about 13 years. It's a beautiful city with tons of different architectural examples. Like, if you wanted to see any kind of American architectural style, Chicago's got it, basically. Anyway, Blair Kamen is a very knowledgeable... Fucking goddamn it! Blair Kamen is a very knowledgeable critic of architecture. His book was very informative. I forget what the book was called. But anyway, if you look up his name, Blair Kamen, B-L-A-I-R-K-A-M-I-N, I think. You'll find it, I'm sure. I don't imagine he's written too many books. Oh, fuck, I just hit the chevron, dude. I'm sure the mission will start. No, it won't. Okay, there we go. Anyway, he talked about the American public housing project and how fucked it is. It's fucked.
I see his car.
He should be heading over to a chop shop in Boabo. Don't get too comfortable with him, Nico. Like every rat, he's a survivor.
He's a survivor.
He bought some protection and he ain't gonna hang around and wait for you know what to happen. Then again, I'll get a chump muscle to stop for gas out of the way. It might create a good opportunity for you.
Wait, I missed that entirely. Anyway, check out Blair Kamen's book. It talks about how fucked up public housing projects were. Basically, back in like the late 70s, early 80s, people were like, oh, you know what everybody loves to do? Everybody loves living in a high-rise. That would be awesome. I bet poor people would really like to live in a high-rise. Isn't that a great idea? People were like, yeah, that's a great idea. Who wouldn't want to live in a high-rise? But what happens is, when you put people in a high-rise, it's basically like taking an entire neighborhood, and instead of it being horizontal with streets and alleys that police can patrol, it becomes vertical and police don't go in it. So the crime and prostitution and drug dealing and pimps and all that shit that would otherwise happen in a city street that police could patrol instead happens in a building that police do not patrol. I don't know what I'm supposed to do here. I don't think I did the right thing here, but okay. Why don't I have my submachine gun? What the fuck is going on here? I don't even know if this is the right car, but a submachine gun would be nice. I don't know how to change guns whilst in a vehicle. Car's gonna explode. Okay, who's left? We need to change cars here in a minute. Fuck! What? No! Son of a bitch. Right when I needed a vehicle the most. I crashed it and it stopped working. God damn it. I seriously need whatever the fucking car I can get. Even if it's a goddamn minivan. No, get in the car, dude. This is not good. Minivan. There I go. Now I've got the submachine gun. What the fuck? Is that it? I'm done? No way. Really? There were like four vehicles.
The meeting went to plan, Mr. Pegorino.
Plain and out's a tough job, Bellic. I don't got much left in mind. It's so clean. I'll talk to you soon.
I killed Ray and I didn't even know it. That's crazy. I can't believe that that worked. Okay, let's go back to the gun store again. I feel like I'm getting close to the end here, so I just want to be absolutely as maxed out as I can be. And then, are there missions left to do? There's nothing, there's just that guy. I don't see any other letters. God damn it. Here we go. This is going to be Darko Brevik.
He's been flown in. We're going to drop him in the airport cargo area.
No more jobs? Is that it? Am I out?
You're out. You've done good things, Russ. We have great. That's it. I've given you a lot of protection. From here in, you're alone. Goodbye.
Okay, this is me going up against Darko Breivik.
Roman, they brought Darko Breivik into the country for me.
Called Roman, okay.
This is almost over. I'm going to finish it.
Nico, you can't do this alone. I'm coming with you. Come collect it. Fire.
No!
Alright.
No! No, don't bring Roman! Why? That's crazy talk, dude. Best case scenario, Roman comes out alive. Worst case scenario is Roman gets killed somehow, and then... No. I don't like this at all. Why the fuck would I bring Roman? Roman's like, he's the dude who's gonna... He's gonna outlive all this. He's getting married.
How is it going, man? Don't shoot at me now!
He has gambling debts and shit, but he's like, he's non-violent for the most part. Seems like a terrible idea. Bringing Roman.
Later.
New car time. Okay, here we go. Don't hit the cop, man. Shit. I need a drink. Hang on, hand. Here we go. Oh, that ain't gonna work. That won't confront me, none. Don't confront me. Oh! George Thorogood and the Destroyers. I happen to just quote a George Thorogood song, that's why I'm saying the name of the band. One bourbon, one scotch, one beer. Nah, 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 nah. I don't have a radio station, so I gotta provide my own. I'm sorry, everyone. Well, I ain't seen my baby since I don't know when. I've been drinking bourbon, whiskey, scotch, and gin. Gonna get high, man. I'm gonna get loose.
I do not want to be late after I've waited so long.
The airport, huh? Leave me a triple shot of that juice. Wanna get drunk? Won't you listen right here? I want one bourbon, one scotch, one beer, one bourbon,
one scotch. One beer. I've not been the same man since the day that Darko betrayed us. Since I saw those things.
You lost a lot of friends that day, Nico.
We lost it. In some way, our friends from the village were lucky. I lost myself that day.
Ah, yes. The dead were the fortunate ones.
If I could live those hours again, I think I would have preferred to be buried in the pit along with everyone else. This is all that is left of me.
I don't know, Nico. I think you enjoy this shit.
What is my trade? I deal in death. Because that is all that is open to me.
I will tell you what you are good at, Nico. You are a good cousin and a good friend. You still have integrity. No matter what you say, there is humanity in you. You still have the power to be good. It's important that you believe that.
Maybe I will start to believe it when Darko is dead. That might
be... I mean, Roman is sweet as hell, but I don't think he's right.
Once this is done, then you must begin to forgive. Think about your future instead of the horrible things that have happened to you. To us! To all of us in the past.
After this is done, then we can talk about forgiveness and redemption. Now is not the time for such conversation.
So, again, I'll mention, and I know I've mentioned before, the only GTA game I've ever played is Vice City, and in Vice City, they're unapologetically, like, be an awful, horrible human being.
Come on.
Commit crimes, kill police, smack hookers, run over pimps, like, it's all about fantasy and just
Hurry up, man, absolutely awful
person. Whereas in this game, they're like, don't give in to hate. That leads to the dark side, my cousin.
This is it. This is where it all
ends. It's like, this game is one giant dark side indulgence. Roman had to put on his stupid shirt for this scene. It's him! Darko Breivik!
You remember me?
Pusteme, ne poznajet. I don't know you.
Yes, you do. I'm the one who survived.
He looks like a mirror image. That's intentional, I'm sure.
Reci mi zašto.
Zašto?
Zato što smo bili prijatelji. Svi smo odrasli zajedno. Mitar. Dragan, Goran, Mio, mogu da nastavim, sviju, ha?
Bernie Crane!
Friends that I am friends! Friends that Goran and his guys killed.
Hey, Darko's pretty good at English.
My fucking neighbors! Because of what? Because of shit. Lies. Fucking lies.
So that makes it okay to stab your friends in the back?
When everything you believe is shown to be shit, you make strange choices.
Fuck you! Strange choices? How much?
1,000.
You kill my friends for $1,000.
How much do you charge to kill someone?
You ruined me, you fuck!
I needed the money. I had problems.
You're a fucking junkie!
Kill me then! You fucking hypocrite. Trust me.
Damn.
You're doing me a favor!
Nico, come on. Let's go. Let him suffer. He knows what he did. It doesn't look like he enjoys life too much. Come on.
I can't kill him.
Come on, Nico. It's time to go.
Roman's the angel on my shoulder saying, don't do this, man. Don't do this. Let's go.
What is this place? You say I ruined you. You were always a killer. I just helped you see that. I'm lost. I'm lost.
We can't do it, man.
Where am I? What is this place?
Will you take me over to Bruce's house?
Yeah, is that where we're going next? Oh, Darko's running for it. Damn, dude. Kind of breaks my heart that Roman was standing there saying, no, come on, you don't want to do this. Come with me. Man. Roman is the heart and soul of this game.
I'm turning this shit off. I can't take listening to those annoying ads and DJs right now.
You did the right thing, Nico. It's not often that a man can be sure of that, but you definitely did the right thing. You're proud of yourself.
Let's have a fucking party. Break out the champagne. I let the diseased, traitorous junkie live after hunting him for over a decade. Shit! Someone hand me the keys to the fucking city.
There's no need to take that tone, cousin.
I'm sorry if my tone offends you, Roman.
Shut up,
this
Nico.
This is a very difficult moment for me. He took every fiber of my being, pulling in the same direction, not to kill Darko, to not get revenge for all those lives he took away.
What made you spare him, Nico?
I don't know.
You did, Roman.
I wanted it for so long, he would just be dead. Like everyone else from our village, I was the one that survived the first attack. Living is not easy.
No.
I would live through killing Darko as well. But then, when I looked at him, I realized that nothing would change if I killed him. Revenge would not somehow shut the book on what I have seen. Only those who die get closure. Living do not.
So you keep living. And you try to have a happy life. You try to move on.
I try to. Yes.
Man, thank God for Roman. Roman might actually be my favorite character in this game now. Now, I know this is totally breaking the mood, but I'm gonna do this jump! Oh, come on, no score for that shit! We jumped onto a fucking runway. Alright, fine, I tried. Let's just get out of here. Wait, where am I going? Oh, I don't know where I'm going. Okay. Wow, game, good job. I liked that ending. I appreciate that. Okay, so you didn't have a choice with Ray and Phil. You just, Jimmy chose Ray for you. But you did have a choice with, wait a minute. You had a choice with Darko, which was cool. Why is that guarded? Just because it's a dock? I was kind of thinking maybe there was like a military base in there. I know Vice City had a military base. I'm wondering where it is in this game, because I bet it exists. Sorry, man, we need your truck. Oh, come on, I work for the airport. Look at me. I am a humble immigrant. I get job working for airport. It's what I do when I come to America. I love this country. I love America. Wait, so where am I going anyway? Scheisse, we're going to a party. But is Roman's wedding the party? It's a crazy thunderstorm. This is very dramatic. Okay, come on, come on, come on. Yeah, there we go. Oh, I can just drive over whoever I want, I think. What does Roman think about all this? Roman does not care.